I think it is a great opportunity for our community to have this access, and we're really pleased with it. Us being a small town, rural community, that's very important to us. Of course, we live very close to a retirement community, and there are some that are excited about it, and then of course there are some that are really reserved about it. So maybe this will help them to know that they'll have somebody here to help them and show them. I hope with the computers being donated that it's going to bring more of the high school students into the library. So hopefully it'll bring them in where they can do research.
And you'll notice that nothing's happening. Nothing is supposed to be happening, yeah. And if you have a computer that you've used before.
I love it. Of course, I like using the computer and working on it. It's great fun. But I think that the older librarians are a little more scared than the younger ones. But they, you know, they're taking it with stride and they're working real well. I think they find out it's not near as hard as they thought it was going to be, and they learn to relax. And then once you get them on there, then they're gone. So it's great.
Friends, Miss Audrey's up with us today, and she's got a mighty pretty little song all picked out here for you that she says there's a bluebird on your windowsill.
There's a rainbow in your sky. There are happy thoughts your heart to feel. They're enough to make you cry.
We instituted six terminals last summer, and our lives will never be the same again. I see old people coming in here and learning how to use the computer. They would never have tried to do that if they couldn't have gotten access to it here. And of course, the youngsters come in, they have no problem with this. They think it's great. They play with it. They can't hurt it. They know they can. We're looking forward to having lots of people come in here and create a community where we have lots of folks that are computer literate. It was a matter of us getting acclimated to a world of technology and automation. And we were, as a staff, drug into this kicking and screaming, you know? We're kind of card file freaks, and I'm glad to get away from that, because that's not people time. This is people time. And I think that's what the public library needs to be. And we're all learning, and we're learning more about it ourselves every day. And I think we're where we can say it's good. It's not evil anymore.
So go ahead to the address bar, and if you want to type in www.irs.gov.
I just started about 3.5 weeks ago, so this is a new introduction for me.
GOV, that's right.
And I'm doing the RTH, which is usually a month after they have had their computers, and we teach them how to use the internet and how to do advanced searches on the internet. So that's predominantly what I'm doing now, is just getting them comfortable with moving around on the computer and getting used to what the internet feels like. The biggest thing is learning the mouse. Once they learn how to use the mouse, everything else comes fairly naturally. It takes some practice, as with everything, but I have a hard time peeling them away from the internet. Once we get that started, they'll keep playing, and I'm trying to teach a class, and I'll have to get their attention somehow. So it's really fun. They have a great time. It's a big world out there on the internet, so it seems like you learn something new every time. And that's what I find in the classes, that the librarians are just amazed at some of the things they can do on the internet. And it works both ways. There are a lot of things, even in just going through the curriculum, that I wasn't aware of. Some of the search tools you can use. So it's new for me, too.
The world is literally at the fingertips of every patron who comes in here. There is no library that can afford to have everything, information on everything, through books, but through the internet and the software that's on here, they can. And these rural communities, some people are intimidated by this new technology, but it is the future. It's the present for that matter. One thing that this means for our patrons is that it opens up a whole world of information that to match, you would have to buy tens of thousands of books. We don't have the space for the books. We don't have the money for the books. But it's all there on the web, right here, Helena, Arkansas.
Here's a song I wrote quite a few years ago. We'd like to do it for you now. Hymn Time. I Saw the Light.
I wandered so aimless, life filled with sin. I wouldn't let my dear Savior in. Then Jesus came like a stranger in the night. And praise the Lord, I saw the light. I saw the light.
Every 3 o'clock, boy, the libraries really get busy. We know when school's at because they really come in to use our computers. And we help them as much as we can.
They're busy all the time. The library I came from, the town had a population of 70,000, about 10 times what this library has, and it had no more computers than this library has. And yet, given the small population here, we could probably use more computers. We don't have the space, but we could certainly use them.
And the children that come in, if they just come in and they go to the back and they pick out a book and they hardly say anything to us, we don't get to know them like we do. If they sit at the computer and we have to help them do something, then we get to know them a little better.
The computer will never replace what you have. It will never replace it. People still want to come in and have the book in their hand. There's something about going to bed, read a book, that going to bed with a laptop just doesn't match.
Friends, we got to get out of here. We're running a little bit late. The clock is really caught up with us. This is Hank Williams speaking for all the boys and myself, saying if the good Lord's willing and the creeks don't rise, we'll see you again right shortly.
Tutor students after school that choose to come here and get extra work on their homework and whatever needs that they have, we help them with it. And we work on, when students don't have homework to do, we find extra activities and enrichment activities. And sometimes we do work on the computers, and that's something that they don't get to do much. Some of my students know more about it than I do, actually. I had a student last semester and we had the older computers, and those are the ones I'm not familiar with. And I didn't know how to get to a different prompt or call up a program, and they were showing me how to do it. So these kids know a lot more about computers than I did at their age, just because they're exposed to a lot more.
I tell you, it's gonna be funny. My little girl taught me how to turn on the computer. And at that age, I think she was 6. And she'd been learning how to work a computer since she was 4.
These computers are great for doing research, when children have questions. There's so much more information that we don't have at the library that you can't even find at our university library that you can get on the internet. And it just opens so many more worlds for them. They can find anything that they're interested in, and it just makes learning a lot more fun for them, enjoyable. They want to work on the computers, and they want to be able to learn. And I've seen the students go from not even being able to turn on the computer to they're showing the other ones. We have the screen that they can use the monitor. And I have other students teaching the other students how to shut down the computer and showing them how to play the different games and do word processing. And to see them learning and to see the grades improve, and that really is rewarding.
When the computers came, we had everything set out on the tables and all, and then the representatives from Gates came, and they hooked everything together for us and did this at each one of our branches too. And they were very helpful. They went through the basics of being a network administrator, how to add things to the different profiles and just the basic things to get us started. And that was very helpful. The help that I've gotten from Help Desk, every time that I call them, I have developed what I call my computer problem log. And when someone reports a problem to me, I've discovered I needed this when I started having 5 or 10 people a day calling with questions. And I was getting confused over which problems I still had and which ones I didn't. So I developed this form called the computer problem log. And all of the people that work here, when they have a problem, they write it down, the problem on a report, and they send it in to me. And I take them in order and I go through the problem. And then I write down my solution. Whatever I do to resolve that problem, I keep record of the solution. So actually, when our year runs out with the technical support, I will have a lot of records to look back on and how we handled a lot of cases when they occurred. I think it's very exciting that libraries are getting into the computers for patrons. I think it's wonderful for people to have access to the internet. There's so much information out there. I mean, it's not that I think it will replace libraries. I don't think anything could ever replace a library. It's just something extra. It's just something extra that libraries can offer to people, and I think it's really good. I'm very excited about it.
We will be twice as busy as we are now because people really can't wait to get on the computers, because now that they know that they can come in and type papers here, we will be probably inundated from 9 until 6 o'clock until we close every day.
So let's go back with it, John.
When we first got the word that we were going to get the computers, they seemed like it was going to be very difficult to be trained on, and I kept saying, oh my goodness. How, you know, they were saying you need to be well trained on it before you can train the public, and I thought, oh, to myself. But when I went for training yesterday, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was going to be. And it's good to have, you know, the internet right at our fingertips, because of the fact a lot of times information in the books are dated and you can get right to information on the computers. But I have thoroughly enjoyed it.
There you are, folks. Garden seed fiddle and a little bit of the Arkansas traveling.